Senior prize giving. First of all, I just want to make a few announcements and thanks. So thank you to the Spit Race Company. I hope you guys all enjoyed your dinner. Can we have a round of thanks for the Spit Race Company, please? Thank you also to Scott and Zoe behind the bar this evening. They all look after us, so thanks Scott, thanks Zoe. Alrighty. The format tonight is pretty similar to the last few prize givers. If you've come along before, we are going to do team speeches first, then we're going to have a little pause, and then we'll have the club speeches. There's a few other guest appearances this evening intermingled in between the presentations, so look out for those. But to kick things off, I would just like to acknowledge what a great season we've had. Over 950 wickets taken by Burnside West Christchurch University Cricket Club bowlers this year, 21 fives. Over 20,000 runs scored across all of the different teams in men's cricket, from premiers all the way through to cavaliers, including 12 centuries scored by our club members. So well done to all the batsmen. 18 players achieving higher honours in various formats, ranging from representative cricket all the way up to the New Zealand men's national team. 6 international representatives in the men's club this year. So well done to all of those guys, and we'll acknowledge you in a slide later on. But well done to everybody. So I think it's been a great year, and of course this happened as well. Congratulations to the photographer. I don't know who managed to recreate this, but I think they did a pretty fantastic job. I'm sure we'll hear from Matt and Carl and a few others over the course of tonight as they just explain what this photograph is about and what the significance of those two images are. So well done to the Premier Men for the great achievements of this season too. I would now like to pass on the microphone Mr. Hay.
Certainly all welcome to all players and supporters, and we've got a couple of live members here. Someone's here to meet two peas in a pod, Shane Young and Peter Isle. And also we've got Dave Hooper here, who was on the original committee of the club, and he's going to be presenting an award later in the evening. Look, I'm fortunate enough to be gone along to the Junior Northwest Woman prize giving in the last 2 weeks. What I can say is right through the club, there's a really good vibe, I guess, if those watch the castle. You know, the vibe is really good in the juniors. You can see that the young boys and girls are really enjoying their cricket, and we've got a lot of support from their parents right through to our Northwest women's teams and what have you. So tonight we are here to congratulate and recognise the success we have in the club. It has been an exceptional year in achievement across the club, but also I think also in respect to the culture of the club improving year on year out. The way that between teams players have been happy to change teams and fill in gaps, move up, move down, it's been very well received by those trying to organise teams. So enjoy your night. We look forward to seeing you in October, September, October, later in the year. Have a very good off season. And as I say, congratulations to all the award winners tonight. Just a special mention, Tom Inder is away to India tomorrow. He's in the New Zealand Department. So, congratulations to Tom. Enjoy that. I think Ray's going as well. So, have a blast. It'll be really good. As we know, as Gareth has also said, you know, Roy Rourke flew out today on his way to Pakistan to rep New Zealand. So really good stuff happening in the club. Thanks, Gibbo. He loves putting this together. He's a great MC.
He does. He loves it.
His work tonight. And just to mention to the committee, thanks for all the hard work during the season as well. A lot of people behind the scenes making the club tick along. Special, just to finishing, we've got some sponsors here and people that have donated money for the club. Thank you, much appreciated. Enjoy your evening. Thank you. Alrighty, thank you, Peter. We are now going to kick on with the awards. So we're going to go through all the teams. And we're going to start things off with the sticky wickets. Can I please have JT Longley?
Just a huge thank you to Gary, organised all the T20 stuff for us, and also our junior liaison, Scott Jenner. So if anyone is wondering why we're here tonight, it's because of him. So if anyone does anything stupid, blame on Scott. And thank you for an awesome season. It was a lot of fun. And hopefully next year, Duck Six, we need trust with that iPad of yours. Because we'd love to have a score this year if we can count it over, James. Thanks, mate.
Well done, Jason.
It's great to have you guys along to the prize giving for the first time. And with that, let's roll on to the Duck Duck Sixes.
Awesome that we've got another Cavs team here tonight. So first of all, thanks to the Sticky Wickets. But the only score that matters is 2-1 Duck Duck Six. So the Duck Duck Sixes. We're not a bad season. I think we finished fifth overall. The teams that finished above us, I think we ended up beating in the regular season. So I guess I feel a little bit disappointed that we're not higher up, but that's the way cricket goes. I'd like to make special mention tonight of a guy that's sort of been with us for the last 3 or 4 years. He sort of kind of picked up cricket about 4 years ago, but he's been cricket mad ever since. And this season against New Brighton, he top scored for his first time. And he got to the figure of retiring for the very first time. So Thomas Gibbons, well done, mate. And the other thing I'd like to point out about Thomas and Jess is they put in a lot of hours behind the scenes. They've organised our end of season getaway and they sort out the play HQ and stuff, so that's really appreciated. Thanks, Gilbo and Jess. Michael Parrish, he's sort of carried us this season. I think he's finished up with about 680 runs. And he had to retire at 50 about 8 times. So that's the way it goes again. Yeah, and then my final thought while I'm up here is Jacob Jarvey has finally got a girlfriend after how many years? And he managed to get her down to the cricket. So right on, Jacob. So our best batter of the year, no surprises, goes to Michael Parrish. Best bowler of the season, breaking the record for most balls bowled in an over with 14. Carl Simpson. Probably worth noting that we play pretty generous whites as well, so 14 balls. Yeah, and we went for 12 runs. And then our best fielder, who is not present tonight, so Jess, you can come up in his place, Todd Revere. Also, Duck Duck Six, we're about to go on away on our end of season trip. So we're running a court session sort of as we speak. So if you've got anything and you see the boys doing anything that they shouldn't be doing, come and let me know. We'll make sure we add it on. Thank you.
Well done, James. Thank you.
hope we'll have Fox and Lady back next year. Thanks. That's shit. Right, so if you turn that TV off, it's not great reading this season in terms of the Foxes' performances. On the park, off the park, as always, we were probably the greatest contributors to the bar, tally, and also to local alcohol outlets across the city for half-time, pre-game, during-game, and after-game. Pretty tough season, like I said. We really suffered from the loss of a number of key players. Guys like Marty Conway, Grant Dixon, getting injuries. At times, it was frantic late Friday to try and get the 11th player. And I really appreciate the support from the wider club in that regard, particularly the Div 4 guys who fronted for us at times and others. A really enjoyable season, though. Sometimes adversity brings togetherness. We didn't need that because we've always had togetherness. We're a very happy group of guys that just want to have a lot of fun play cricket on Saturday. We remain competitive. I guess some season highlights would be some of our older members, not myself, obviously, moving through and playing some veteran cricket, which has become huge across the globe, really, and we'll talk about that more. In terms of our top performance, Gareth. Our best batsman this year was a guy that actually only played about 9 or 10 games, but comfortably had the highest score for the season and also had the most runs for the season. And that's the legendary Chris Kennedy. Shortly, but Arkell was at the ripe old age of 16 plus GST, made the New Zealand over 16 team, which toured India for the World Cup, and he certainly featured in a pretty significant partnership in one game with another Burnside Lynx player in Craig Gibb, father of Nick. Our best bowler this season, well, this man needs no introduction, mainly because he's already introduced himself. He got 30 wickets at, I'm not sure what, because he hasn't pushed the button yet, but he's right next to me. The Fox's bowler of the year is Gareth Gibb. Our best fielder, a bit of a difficult one to choose in Masters grade cricket, because a lot of us don't move as smoothly, as lively, as gracefully as we used to. My problem with the session, just statistics say that I took 8 out of 9 catches at mid off, which is a far cry from my 1 out of 9 last year at Slips, so we've made some changes, but unfortunately it's not me this year. This year our best fielder is a guy who I would describe as unorthodox, spirited, motivated, and probably most of all quickly across the ground, and that's Stefan. Next one's a big one, obviously, probably the elite award that you'll hear tonight, the Masters Player of the Season. This guy is a week in, week out contributor to the team. He's a good human being. He's a pretty handy fielder, but he can't win everything. He's one of our stock bowlers that bowls, I'm not sure what he bowls at, maybe he can tell us later. But this year, when called upon in situations where we were wickets down for not many runs, this guy stepped up with the bat to aid to his probably 22 to 25 wickets. Player of the year for the Foxes is Mike Whelan. Yeah.
Alrighty, thank you David. Now time for something a little bit different, something we haven't done before at the Bench Soccer Club prize giving. I'd like to call this segment Crash on the Couch.
No one's talked about the decks this year at Burnside, so that'll be an issue if that doesn't happen. I'm just going to invite Chris Kennedy from the Foxes to come up. No one could be bothered bringing the couch up from downstairs, so we're crashing on the stool at the moment, if you don't mind. Arkle, your nickname, where did that come from?
When I was a schoolboy, I got invited to go down and bowl at the touring in Woodside, and they had young Ian Botham and Derek Randall. Derek Randall, his nickname was Arkle. He called me aside and got me to do some throwdowns for him. Apparently put on a few of his mannerisms after that, a bit of a role model. And Justin Ball when I named me up when I joined the club. Yeah, so stuck it since, yeah.
Sensational. Now, must have been very proud this year, obviously. I'm not sure if you played for New Zealand in any form of sport or representative mode previously, but to make the New Zealand over 60s team go to a World Cup. How hard did you have to work for that, Arkle?
Matt got me on strength and conditioning program and worked pretty hard at that. But first time representing the country would be, so it was pretty special. I'm pretty proud. And guys are pleased to know when I was batting over there, I was batting in my boots, so we're sloppy. So a bit of exposure to the club overhead. But it was great.
Nice. And obviously World Cup, I think it was in Chennai in India. Any highlights for you of the tour?
I think the highlight was playing South Africa and great crowd of guys. You guys know the rivalry between South Africa and New Zealand, but it's still the same when you're old. Great crowd of guys and we're chasing a sort of a target and made it a bit up our runway. So fortunately batting with Gilly, Craig Dibnicks, it's there. And we put 195 and Gilly got a great time. And it's a real trick down the phone. I think he's even the best player in the family. But
now, a group of 60 plus guys travelling to overseas, let alone to India, must be a funny story or two in there.
Well, just a couple of quick ones. The first game we played, match manager told us that we didn't go and try and retrieve the balls out of the long grass. So there's too many snakes in there. They had a couple of young boys to go and do it for us. And the other one that springs to mind is playing Zimbabwe and chasing 250 on a track that looked like the dance floor out there. We're just going to test it. And set to open the batting with Gibby and really looking forward to it. And night before, I had a chicken tikka masala. So we were batting second, and over lunch, I decided I need to have a shit. So we went off to pad up, and food in the soil, there's no toilet paper in there. it wasn't straightforward after that. And we went out to bat, so, and the open was put on 150, so missed out here. But as part of my pre-match routine after that, it was taking Imodium for the game, which is a clock shot, so he has a drowsiness.
Nice, and that probably joined last week. We've been at the club a long time. We won't ask you to recount the exact date, but a long and fruitful innings with Burnside, which hopefully will continue. Top scorer for the Foxes this year, remaining safe for 9 games. What does the club mean to you? What does it mean to put on the baggy maroon?
Well, it's fantastic. I've started playing here in about 72. It's all about the guys you play with and the guys in the club. It's been fantastic. Great to see you guys performing so well. All the other sides enjoying it. The club's in such a great heart. Thanks to the committee. Just encourage you guys to keep playing. After you've done your sort of your serious stuff, that's the Prezies is a good place to go. Special place for me, and great for you guys to be a part of it. Cheers.
All right, thanks.
Alrighty, thank you David. Interesting innovation. Alright, the Robbie's Masters team aren't here tonight. They've had some things going on, but they are also on their team trip this year. We thought that we would try to do a live cross, but it's a time cancel that, and maybe we'll come to it in the innings break. But they had a pretty successful year, lots of wins. They made it into the top six on the back of only losing a couple of their games in the round robin. Mixed bag in the top six, but a pretty fantastic year. They had some fantastic performances in their team. A guy called Steve McKean, who most of you will know, Steve McKean, War Machine.
Steve McKean!
Yes! Pretty close, so about 593 runs at 49.2, which is an exceptional season. Their best bowler was Mark Senior himself, 29 wickets at 12.9, and their best fielder in the start of the season was Adrian McFedry's 316 runs, scored his first century for the club, took 19 wickets in my catcher. So well done to the Robbie's boys, even though they're here. And with that, we will jump to the Broncos.
Started strong, and just Bansy actually said we've never started with 2 wins, so it's only down from here, and sure enough, it went down. So he's not here. I think he's still in hiding. We had a few guys go away earlier in the season. Jono left for a new career change. He's up at Blessed College right now and graduates next month. He's passed all his things, surprisingly. I don't know how to still get him in there. But nevertheless, he's there. We had a couple of guys go away with some family stuff. We get older, our shirts get tighter, the injuries start to pile on, so we had a few guys drop off, but I managed to lure some of the old boomers who were back in the day back, and hopefully retain them for next season. So there's a few good bits of hope for us for next year. We've had, I think we used 38 players this year. From last year we had 19. We were scratching. It was a lot to Jono Collins actually, and the North West boys. We had quite a few of them play for us, and it was nice to have some boundary riders. certainly made our lives a little bit easier, and sitting down the pub afterwards was a lot more relaxed. Best batter of the year, we usually count on him every year to try and get us some runs, but he's got a cool mind when he's out there in the middle, and he's a pleasure to bat with actually. There's a lot of guys in our team that want to try and clear the rope, and he's, as he'll famously tell you, he's never hit a six in the Southern Hemisphere. So he's a nice guy to bat with, and to just a graft. So that's Chris.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The bowler, it was hard to pick actually. We had quite a few guys all around the same sort of wickets, but he only played half the season, but his strike rate and accuracy when he was bowling was outstanding. And it was actually a shame to see him go, but that was Jono. He's not here tonight, so Samuel. it's hard to pick a fielder really, I suppose. It always seems to go to keep for us. A lot of fielding down the leg side, diving through the offside. He had many go through nicely to him, but that's Roger. He standing a couple of stumpings, some great catches, involved with a lot of run outs, so he's not here either, so where's he?
Right, so I've just been pinged by the offsite people in, I don't know where they are, so we'll just try something really quickly and do a live cross. This has never happened before in a Burnside West Crossroads University Cricket Club. Secret prize giving before, if they answer, they're going to do something special for us, I think, or I hope they are. There we go, there's Stu. Hey guys, welcome to the prize giving. You can see yourselves up on the window there. As promised, this is your opportunity to say one thing, chop your beer, give us a wave.
And turn your phone around.
Turn your phone around.
Turn your phone around, please, because you're sideways. It is sideways, this is. Okay, there we go. All right.
Yay!
Well done. Okay, 3, 2, 1, chop your beer, please.
We've seen it.
Yeah,
oh, speech.
We can't hear you. You're not coming through the loudspeaker. So just drink your beer. Up the waz.
Best batter award goes to someone that actually stepped up and decided to take a ball at the opening halfway through the season, and he done pretty well with this, getting 316 runs, and most of that coming in the last, I think, 6 or 7 games. So that goes to Ben Garvey. Goes to Ben as well. he's not here and he's not as good as Ben, so.
What up, Ben?
And then best fielder doesn't unfortunately go to Ben. Oh. It goes to someone one that we call a football test of the team, which is Donna Collins. I would like to call up.
Well done, Danusia.
Thank you, the Tigers. Starting to get serious now. It is time for the Lions.
Lost in the T20 semi-finals out on number one. Two-day form, because we got split to top six, bottom six. It was always going to be rough for us. A couple of results that we left out on the table. But look, overall, it's a good building season for us. We managed to get a good couple of boys come across from other clubs, which has been really, really awesome for our leadership team. Because a couple of years ago, we sat down and said we want to have a team where people want to come and play for us, to have to get guys like Dooley and Medgar coming across from Ripperton saying they want to play for us. Boys, that's huge, not for just for our team, but for the whole club. So shout out.
Yeah.
Other special mentions, of course, going to go to teams that have helped us out in tough times. So Danusia with the four boys, I think we've got Adam and the Broncos, even the couple of the presents came and played for us a few times. A couple of boys come down from Champs as well, which is huge. And one good thing, especially for me, was Northwest boys. During their summer break, we gave four or five of them, I think it was, their first taste of men's cricket. And that's just only good for everyone in the world. It's the best for them. So on to the awards. An honourable mention just before we do this for best batter and best bowler. Jaco Hauser could have done the Ben McGarvey, but missed out by 2 runs and 2 wickets. So, a bit like next one, son. Best batter goes to basically one of the guys that every day we're out there, you always knew he was going to produce something. Whether that was 50 runs or a wobble duck, it was always entertaining. He's always stepped up for us and basically smoking a guy onto the road at Bishop Vale Park. First ball of the last game was huge, so that goes to Tim Scott. Is our best bowler. Pretty much during the one-day comp, he was the only guy that was ever bowling his full allotment of overs. So he bowled the most deliveries in our team by about 160 deliveries. Highlights include taking a T20 fifer, which included a quadruple wicket maiden. Had never seen it before in any T20 before. So the best bowler for us, Billy. Smallest man on the pitch, covered more ground than basically the rest of us put together. Saved at least a couple of 100 runs. Absolutely.
Championships.
Thanks, Gibbo.
Right, I'll try to get this as short as I can as possible, but however, there are some people that I'd like to thank first and foremost. So, firstly, I'd like to thank the coaching staff of the Prem squad, which goes to Losh and also Baz and Stove. I thought you guys did a fantastic job this year in terms of managing the players that you had and the jobs that you guys did, because it's an unrewarding task unless you win trophies, and obviously that was a good result this year. But first and foremost, thank you guys. Secondly, I want to thank the Div 2 boys this year for their the flawed nature in terms of what came with exchanging players. I know I did this last year, but I thought this year was even better than last. And I just cannot appreciate you guys enough in terms of the uni season, losing players and gaining players that you guys were happy to give when we asked. So thank you boys very, very much, because I know that it makes it tough for you guys as well. Thirdly, committee. Without this, guys, I don't think that many people out here recognise that without the committee that Burnside has, is that we couldn't put teams out on the pitch each week, let alone it being Prems, Twos, Champs, anyone that you want to name. I don't think without the committee, none of this is attainable. So I think there's a massive, massive thank you that is due by everyone for the committee members this year. So just appreciate that if you get the opportunities to. Lastly, to our boys, the core membership that we had this year was not unnoticed. So we used a total of 41 players in the championship team this year, which is ridiculous. And for us to have the season that we did was unfathomable. However, laugh at this magic for the guys that played 98% or 90% of the matches that we had throughout the year was not gone unnoticed, so thank you to those guys. Alright, to move on to the team, we had a roller coaster of a season. In the 2-day competition, we played 7 games, won 5, drew 1, lost 1. A game that cost us a trophy in the end. We ended up 1.9 points behind Rickerton in the final day at the close of play. So it came down to bugger all. In the 1-day competition, we won 3 games, lost 3, abandoned 1, and the one that we abandoned made cross us the place in the semi-finals. So, 2 trophies there, we abandoned. However, it was an up and down T20 campaign for the championship side. Believe it or not, we managed to come out on top in the competition, only winning 1 round robin game. The game that we won, we just so happened to win it well enough to advance through to the semi-finals. In doing so, we won the semi-finals, went through to the finals, and in the game we were chasing 112 from Heathcote's 20 overs, Burnside chased it in 11.3 overs, the main contributor being one of our award winners tonight with a not-out score of 58 off 33. So that brings us to the award winners. Joel Williams this season scored 506 runs and an average of 29.8 with a strike rate of 120 plus with a high score of 93. Well done, Joel.
Well done, Joel.
The bowler of the year this season was another one of those core members that ensured that he played over 90% of the games and was one of the consistent players each week and helped the boys contribute to winning the 2-day trophy. Cameron Scruff Hardwick is the winner of this year, taking 31 wickets and an average of 16.
Congrats your engagement, Cam, as well. Well done, mate.
Our fielder of the the year this year may come as a no-brainer, as it always seems to each year in and year out. This man filled the shield by playing in the Premier One Day Final as Tim Seto unfortunately fell with a concussion. Joel Williams took 16 catches and one stumping throughout this year, earning himself the Champs Year of the Year in his final year at the club. Well done, Joel. Thanks again to everyone. That's the champ.
He'll be back. Well done, Joel.
Last team, and then we are taking a short drinks break, but let's get this done, folks. It's time for the premieres. Firstly, thanks to the club for all the support this year. Obviously, we've had a great season winning both the 1 and 2 day trophies. It was a massive effort. I suppose we prepared really well in the pre-season. We're very lucky to have the coaching team, I guess, that of the three guys sitting in front of me, expertise, but also the desire and want to make us better as a team and a group. Results speak for themselves, I suppose. Fantastic start to the summer, winning 4 outrights in a row in the 2 day comp, which really set the tone. 1 day cricket, I think we've lost 3 games in the last 3 seasons, so we've got a pretty good method there. And then, T20s with a little bit of a dice roll, really, with 2 games and 1 can go away. So, we've had a fantastic season. We've played on really good wickets, thanks, Crash. I think it really suited us. Playing 1 day as we're at the score 280, 300. You can win the games, and that's all often done at Burnside Park. So we scored lots of runs. We had, as a group, we had lots of match winners this year. We had 5 different guys score hundreds, 6 different guys take fifers. So you look at that match winning ability, I think that really set us apart from the other teams in the competition. I guess the exciting thing for us is, we won a lot of games off the back of individual performances, and I think we can grow a lot as individuals. And definitely so much improvement there with such a young group. So I think that's exciting looking forward, because obviously we've got the results in terms of trophies, but I think there's so much more there we can get better. So fantastic season, guys. I think thanks for the buy-in. I think that's the main thing for me and Carl. We really bought and we ripped in at training. It's not always nice down here at 5:30 to 7:30 on a Thursday night. Can be pretty cold, can be pretty hard on your hands, catching balls and that sort of thing. But thanks for the buy-in. I think especially guys that came in and out of the side, it was a tough side to make at times, with guys coming back and really talented players missing out. So thanks for the buy-in, and I guess we've just got to enjoy our winters and come back and try and do it again. Thank you very much.
We'll see you, Manny.
Our best batter probably should have got a shout out in the main speech. 900 something runs. I don't think I've seen a guy bat as well in a club season as this before. I think did get the most runs in the grade, but played on the ground that's 3 times the size of the ground that the guy that the most runs at. So taking nothing away from him, but Scott Turner had a fantastic season. Yeah, took 300s, 80 odd not out in the final. Look, those numbers are pretty impressive in club cricket.
Well, let's get it.
Doesn't mind doing the job into a strong breeze quite often. He's probably the most economical bowler in the league probably for the last 2 or 3 seasons. And he consistently takes 40 plus wickets. So, outstanding season, Matty. Well done,
mate. Thank you!
Obviously, one thing, we're a really good fielding side. I think a massive effort from the coaches to keep pushing us because it can be bloody cold here to practice our fielding and stuff. And being, we're pretty young and fit side, it's a great field. We just had this unbelievable knack of dropping one catch in a game and it being their best player. And the guy most likely to score runs. So hopefully we can rectify that in the next season. But a guy that it's started off semi-reluctantly to win keep, but has become a really, really important part of our side. And no more important, there's a photo that comes up there of me sitting on my bonnet and Carl and Faz, we sat around for half an hour. We thought Joel was a stag dude the day of our final, and Tim was concussed, and we were trying to rack our brains on who could we keep in the final, which was quite major. Does Steve McKean come up? Do we fill a school win? But I think that probably showed just how big a role Tim has in our team and how important he is week to week. So you probably never met Jerry, mate, but he'd be really proud of what you do with your wicket keeping and also your running between the wickets for his two big things. So well done, Timmy.
Well said, man.
Speak for himself. I think some of the catches, he actually stood up and we kept for a game too when Tim was out, but some of the catches as well as the runs are important. He took one headed screamer in the final. Just had an unbelievable season. We really got our success off the back of his performances. So well done, Scotty.
Your patience, we've made it all the way through the team trophies. There's just one last thing to acknowledge in terms of player success, and that is the representative honours. So I'm just going to go through this name list really quickly. If you're here, please stand up. We'll give you a round of applause, and that's all we need to do. So Tom Latham, Will Overall, Mitchell Hay, Matthew Hay, Jackson Latham, Scott Janet, Riley Brady, Oscar Jackson, Jaden Meyer, Henry Christie, Jake Jonas, Stefan Pienaar, Nick Smith, Andrew Mayo, Matthew Everest, Jeff Roy, Chris Kennedy, Raywin Inda, and Arun as well. We'd like to acknowledge our administrators. So please stand up and congratulations on your. Peter Isle always likes to talk at prize giving, so we'll give him a short segment. I'm pretty sure he'd like to sing as well. Lucky for us, we have wireless microphones this year. So, Peter, come up and say your words and sing us a song, please. Yeah.
Thank you, Gemmo. You know the song.
That song?
Just one, gentlemen. You know the song that I used to sing every prize giving? I never change the song. If you know the song, you can sing along with me.
Sarah.
Yes, it's called the Sarah. Sarah.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty? Will I be rich? Here's what she said to me. Hey, Sarah, Sarah, what will be with me? The future's our house to see. Hey, Sarah, Sarah, what will be. When I grew up and fell in love, I asked my sweetheart, will be.
Yeah. Is that including town
that's just over the night here, and it's a rough count.
I remember my red up tab was ridiculous. It was outstanding for Shane. He sprayed $500 balls of my way out, but it's just.
Certainly, people contribute to the club in different ways. Look, Carl, as a young player coming here, you've progressed, obviously, an exceptional player. Then and now, you've become a real leader in the club by taking on the captaincy and then moving through to coaching. Obviously, a couple of great assistants in Stove and Faz.
Look, man, if I could pick anyone around town, I wouldn't go elsewhere. What Stove and Fazzy brings to the table, it's exceptional. The amount of sort of times they don't always say too much, but when they do speak, boys will listen and they'll bring a lot of golden nuggets to guys. And just even thinking back 2 days ago, I was speaking to Nick Smith and sort of the chats he's had with Bears and the growth that we've seen and the guys that come through and sort of I think as well, we're measuring stick with guys going on to play high performance cricket. And, this is the sort of stuff we want.
Yeah, absolutely awesome, Carl. Obviously this season, you've in your time under Paul O'Brien, obviously getting that one day monkey off our back and then the 2 day comp last year, to win both this year, and bearing in mind that dates back to 91, 92 and the photo on the wall, where does this sit for you in terms of your highlights of your career at Bensville?
Yeah, certainly will be right at the top, mate. I think that first win under Paul was outstanding to break down. I think that was more for Scotty than for anyone else, to be honest. At that stage, you just feel guilty. A bloke that's that good, it's not won any trophies. It's just how's that even possible? And I think the difference probably now is not so much. We probably have slightly more talent, probably, and more match winners. But I think the difference is just once we get to those situations, it's sort of, we just feel like we're going to win. Where's Pete? Then we probably just, I wouldn't say we choked, but we sort of just, as soon as the moment got a little bit big, we probably walked backwards, where now we probably take a few steps forward and just, just front up. And big moments, we seem to win them quite a bit.
Oh, God, that's awesome. Two last questions. Picks play right this year?
Yeah, mate. I think the decks out on number one was outstanding, to be honest. Yeah. There's a few games there where we were scoring 250 plus just for fun, really, against a Shirley and both of the finals as well. It was outstanding. And probably from memory, the most 100 score at the club, probably in my time. So, that must say something, Christian.
That leads into my next question, which is a lot of people think that number four more love than number one. That's not true. But I'll ask you now, you've got to answer in front of the crowd. Future Fox.
You're
not fucking playing for Robbie.
The catchment's not good, mate. They're
fucking light on sponsorship this year.
Robbie's had his ties to the boys, mate. They try their best, but the Fox is the original club, the original team. So at some stage, I'm sure we'll pull that together and hopefully I can be around the Prems a little bit longer. But certainly, when that time's right, the transition
will be. Wasn't this year, mate. But congratulations on what you achieved with your coaching group, and obviously, Matt's been a fantastic leader for us as well. Well done. We'll see you next season, mate.
Thanks, mate.
We're into the club trophies. A lot of these trophies are very old. There's a bit of a story about each trophy that's up on the screen. I'm not going to read it out to you, but you're welcome to absorb that information. They were donated by various members of our cricketing community over many, many years. I think the oldest trophy that's up for grabs here is around 50 years old or so. So there's some long list of names. With that said, really appreciate if you look after the trophies. A few of them are getting a little bit tatty now. We're going to have to repair some of them. Also, please don't take your trophies home, because we need to keep them in the cabinet so that they don't go AWOL. We've lost a couple over the last 5 years or so. So please enjoy receiving your trophy. You're welcome to have a drink out of it. Celebrate with your mates.
have a photo, but please leave it here at the end of the night. The first trophy is one of a pair of trophies from Ralph Byrne, the batting and a bowling trophy, but this is for the best bowling, sorry, the best performing afternoon grade batter, and he's been a medal winner already this evening, and that is Michael Parrish for 600 yards. An exceptional aggregate in the grade that is difficult to score a lot of runs in a season, so well done, Michael.
A strike rate of 186.
The Russ McLean Trophy for the highest individual score in an innings. Nick Gibb, 151. Very good, congratulations, Nick. We'll see what we can do to. Actually, no, we're not going to send a trophy to you, but I hope you enjoy the weekend. There we go. The Norman Palmer Trophy for the best individual batting innings. This is a difficult one to award because it's not really done on the number of runs that you score, it's done based on the importance or the significance of the innings. It's a club wide trophy. It generally tends to go to a senior player in morning grades trophies because we do put a little bit more emphasis on the quality of the innings and the quality of attack. This year, the Norman Palmer Trophy for the best individual batting innings goes to Scott Janet for 124. Scott should probably park himself up here because I think this is going on for a couple of tomorrow. JL Kerr, most of you should know what the JL stands for, but it's Jack, and he is an absolute legend of the club, going back many, many years, involved in a huge number of roles. A New Zealand Test cricketer, 89 matches for Canterbury, played senior cricket for the club until 1956, when he was still 49, so Carl is still a way away from playing Masters grade, it would seem. This is for the best batter in morning grade cricket, and I said that he should stay up here. But he didn't listen to that. But you should really stand up here. This year we do have a special presentation of the Dave Hooper Runs Trophy. So this is an important trophy in the club. Actually, we've been missing for a few years and we were quite distraught. We didn't know where it was. And it turned out that it was in the kitchen the whole time, stuck behind the fridge. But this year, I'm not sure if you all know or not, but Dave Hooper is actually here with us to help present the trophy. This trophy goes back to 1980. Dave played a lot of cricket for the club in his past, and I'm just thrilled that he's come along tonight to help us present this award, and hopefully he can tell us a little bit of a story about this evolution.
First of all, I'd like to say that it's been a wonderful night. I congratulate all you people who have won awards. It's a marvellous thing that you've all done. And I think that to have so many representative players in the club was a great achievement, and I congratulate you all.
It is on.
I joined the club after a disappointing season or two with another club. And from then on, we had an old pavilion down below, which was an old concrete one, and this is a tabulous, a new word. it's great what you've done to the whole club and the area. It's, you know, you've got inside high, people like that, where you can draw cricketers from, which is really good. I never ever trained here because I lived in Sydney and I wasn't going to bike all the way out here during the week to train. But anyway, I have enjoyed my years at cricket and I have to give it up after 20 odd years or whatever it was here, and I had to take on something like bowls, an old man's game, and I'm an old man. Anyway, the advent of this trophy, I managed to talk to one of the committee members one day, and he was saying that he wanted to get a wee bit more life into the club, and it was nowhere near as big as this. And so he said, wonder if we can come up with something to get a bit of interest. So I went home and I thought about it, went out to the shed and found an old toilet seat. As you can see what it is. So I fixed it up and painted it up. And then it was a matter of what we were going to call it. Well, I thought, being a toilet seat, Runs Trophy would be a good idea. We've all had those sorts of problems. So anyway, we made it Runs Trophy, we got it all. There was a glass of beer on it at one stage, I thought. Anyway, I've thoroughly enjoyed my time playing for Burnside West, Burnside originally, and I was saying about the high scores in the West Christchurch side. Well, we had a couple of very high scores in the Burnside. Jack Reeves, who used to play for High School Old Boys, he had a lovely innings of 151. He beat me by 3 runs.
Yes.
The only problem was I was not there. And to make matters worse, I had my first game on Sydenham Park. I only lived down the road. And we were playing matches. And that's what they call suburban competition. And we had our first day. And we were playing on one ground down one side of the park. And the next Saturday, Sydenham, the senior side, was playing on the number one green at Sydenham Park. And I made my high score of 148 not out.
That's a hell of a score.
And to make matters worse in Sydney, I had 3 sixes in a row into their pitch. So I was quite pleased. And I got really rocked up up in the tea line. It's good to see a good crowd here tonight. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. Thank you very much. And Basta, well done. And also to the caterers. So thank you very much for having me. I hope I can possibly come back again some other time.
Okay, and as we said, the DJ Hooper Runs Trophy for the top run scorer in the season across all morning and afternoon grades. It probably goes without saying, he's been up here a lot already. Scott Janet, 9 minutes. Thank you. Ryan Walby and take them here at the administration of that one. We're back to Ralph Burning here, this time for his bowling edition for the best bowling performer in afternoon grade cricket. Thank you, Raywin. Raywin's also made a donation of his bowling trophies this year because bowlers are more important and batsmen is a little goodie in there. I just wanted to do a little quick shout out. Raywin's doing a fundraiser for Tom. You can go and see her. She's selling these big koozies, is that what they're called? Go and see if you want one, helping to raise a little bit of funds there for Tom to get him over to wherever he's going. I can't remember where that is, but good luck, Tom, when you go. Oh, well, we also point out that he was a representative player as well. We didn't make the list. Apologies from me for that. So, wasn't my fault. All right, Ralph Burn Bowler Trophy. Ben McGarvey, 38 wickets in Division 4 at 10.7. Ben's gone, but your other Ben, faux Ben. The Jubilee Cup for the most wickets in an innings, or in a match, or in a season. So this one changes a little bit year to year, depending on what's happened over the course of the year. Sometimes it's for a bowler who's taken a ridiculous amount of wickets. Sometimes it's for someone who had an amazing innings or an amazing match. This year, it's for an amazing innings.
You wish you're on your shirt now, mate.
J.S. Patrick Cup, perhaps the most aesthetically pleasing trophy in the cabinet, in my opinion at least. J.S. Patrick was a life member. He lived from 1934 to 1985, and this his photo's on the wall up there, and a number of these photos. And this is awarded for the best spin bowler in the club this year. Cameron Hardwick, third on the list.
Well done, Cameron! Go, Scrub!
Okay, the BJ McKibben Trophy for the best overall morning grade bowler. And again, starts to come down to more than just wickets, impact on the pitch, among other things. This year, the BJ McKibben Trophy goes to Alex Tate, 24. Okay, the Marty McEwen Trophy.
Oh, here we go.
The most improved under 21 player in morning grade sides. Nick Gibb, not here tonight. We're going to have a show. Congratulations, Nick.
Hold on, Gibby!
The next couple of awards are the MVP. So, MVP's bit of a mathematical calculation. It's something that we've done in various ways at various times over various seasons. As we've moved from the non-digital era to the digital era, the way that we've done it has changed. It used to be that the captains of each side would submit their best players of the week to somebody else in the committee, and they would compile an Excel spreadsheet that was very manual and very labour-intensive. Then Cricket HQ came along and it became a lot easier all of a sudden. And then Cricket HQ went away and they replaced it with Play HQ and it became really, really difficult again. I've instituted a new system this year, and this is a photograph of Stenchy, or a video of Stenchy trying to figure out the maths behind how this is calculated each year. But we do have two. Sides and we have an MVP for morning grade sides. The Robertson Cup was presented to the club a couple of seasons ago by our esteemed grounds convener David Arnold Robertson. And this year, the Robertson Cup for the best afternoon grade player, or the most valuable player in afternoon grade side, is Ben McGarvey, 29 wickets at 30.
Again, Ben has left it because he didn't realise that beyond team prizes there were club prizes at six. Anyway, all right, now the Al Brown Trophy, the one that everybody wants to win for the most performance points across all grades. This is open to both morning grade and afternoon grade players. It usually goes to morning grade players because they play a lot more cricket for a lot longer. As a bowler, you can bowl more than 8 overs, which helps. And this year, once again, the Al Brown Trophy for the most performance points across all grades, Matthew Haig. We are nearly there. We have two more awards to give. The last two of the Club Service Awards. I like giving these awards out the most because they are given to people that give themselves to the club. It's not just about them and their cricketing capabilities. It's about what they give back. We have a senior merit award for outstanding contributions to the senior club, and we have the McGibbon Cup for best all-round club member. There is a trophy for this one, but again, I don't know where it is. So this is one of these ones that's gone walkabout. He did mention that he'd like to get an award tonight. And so this year, the senior merit award goes to David Arnold Robertson. And I just want to recognise David for the efforts that he put in for all of, for the Masters side, but also the huge number of hours that he's put into preparing amazing wickets across the place. So this year, senior merit award, David Robertson. WS McGibbon Trophy. I think this is the best looking trophy in the cabinet. This year we have decided to give it to two members of the club. The McGibbon Trophy is for the best all-round club member and the member of the club that has a great contribution on the park but also contributes off it. So it's awarded to players or club members that really encapsulate the spirit of what it is to be a Burnside cricketer. They're usually people that want to give back and do give back. And so this year we're awarding it to a couple of guys. The first is to a person who didn't actually play a whole lot of cricket this year but still turned up the entire season, which I think is really admirable. He was involved with the administration of his side, and I think as a representation, the fact that he was here almost every weekend or there with the team almost every weekend just shows how dedicated he is to his mates and to the club. And that's James Gildender. And the reason that we're going to do David Zorab this year is that he's always the first person to put his hand up to help, whether it's covers, whether it's taking rubbish downstairs, whether it's just doing something that's asked of people when we need a little bit of a hand. And so I think I just wanted to acknowledge that and thank him for that. He's also had a great year on the park as well. So well done, James. Well done. Everybody, I hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for your patience. I know that it's a long haul. The bar is open for a while yet. Have a great night. Good night.
Good night, good night.